It's already 1942, end of 1942. The ghetto shrunk. You didn't see any more old people because they were killed. You didn't see any children because they were gone. The majority of us was young people in the teens, in the early 20s. These young people, this group of young people, finally start to organize. Then that was the time when I got in touch with some of the young people, which was Homer Hatzair. That was a Zionist organization. The founder and the one who was really the most famous one was Anielewicz. He was a young man. He was 22. He was a very bright young man. He graduated high school. And he was a shy man, as far as I remember. But how wonderful he talked. And he told us we have to do something. Not to survive, because how can you survive? How can you fight a German army when no European country could? But at least to die with dignity. At least to make sure that the world will know that it's not true that the Jews went like sheep to the slaughter, because God knows it's not the truth. Every day what we survived was a fighting case, but especially with us. So we start to think what we can do. We built bunkers, and no one person knew everything about the bunker, because we was concerned if somebody will be caught and under the circumstances being beaten, how much they will say. So I didn't know everything either, but we try to make sure that you know just enough what you have to know. So we had bunkers, we built bunkers. Ours was on Świętojerska 30. The broom factory was Świętojerska 32. Świętojerska 32, and this was Świętojerska 30, was the bunker. And there wasn't just one bunker, there was plenty. There was a nice few bunkers, even in our broom factory. Some people risked their life, went on the Aryan side, and smuggled some ammunition, for which we paid a tremendous amount of money, because the Poles really didn't try to help us. That's the complete opposite. But there was between them some decent people. So we got a little bit of ammunition from the Aryan side. And most of the things what we did ourselves were the Molotov cocktails in the basements, which is nothing more than a bottle of gasoline with a piece of material. And if you put a match to it, it blows up. And we prepared in the bunkers some food, and we made sure that we will have a supply of water, and the air used to come from the chimney, and the bunkers was built, our bunker was built in the basement, in a corner of the basement. To get to the bunker, you got through to the window sill in the apartment, which opened, and he went through that, through a letter, to the basement. And in the basement, there was a hidden place, and you walked into the base, to the bunker. What I'm very proud of, and I want history to know about it, that this little Warsaw Ghetto fought it much longer than any country in Europe. As you know, some countries was handed to Hitler without any fighting at all. Czechoslovakia, Austria. Then France didn't fight at long. Belgium didn't fight at all. Holland didn't fight at all. So the only countries which was left free in Europe, really, was Switzerland and Sweden. And not mentioning, of course, Russia, which was fighting, in England. The rest, everything was occupied by the Germans. And none of the countries was fighting as long as this little Warsaw Ghetto